Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to OverAnalyzed, our awesome Overwatch coaching series. And today we're going to take a look at the brand new soldier. Now, this soldier is very, very strong if you know what you're doing. So this video is going to serve as sort of like an example of how to play soldier, but also maybe there'll be some advice on things to look out for. Now, this player in question, they've got a very specific set of needs. They say they need coaching because they just can't get out of bronze. So yes, this is a bronze game. But one thing I do want to say about that is a lot of stuff which you will learn, like in bronze and silver, you can apply to gold and platinum, and maybe even above. Because if you think of it this way, you're setting yourself up for, you know, you're preparing to win, right? You don't prepare to fail, do you? So if you've got a good foundation, a good knowledge base, and that comes from developing good habits, which honestly is kind of easy to do with Soldier. He is a very sort of run-of-the-mill character, and he is pretty easy to get a ton of value from, but this player will be making a lot of bad decisions. So this is what the player, it's not that soldier, although I guess any soldier really wouldn't matter at this point. It is Jonathan we're going to look at. So this soldier player says they're stuck in bronze. They deserve to be in gold. We hear that a lot. They also say they get gold damage in the limbs in basically every game, and they think their main problems are use of biotic field, weird, and helix rocket. So one thing I'm going to say straight away here is we are actually in, right? I'm going to pause this. Okay, we're running away. Okay, let's not pause this. Let's see what you do. Because there are two key things missing from your analysis of your play or the problems of your play. What is going on here? There's no mention of flanking, which is, a massive, massive part of Soldier 76. We're actually going to just pause this here because this is actually kind of funky. All right. Let's get stuck into this before we derail any further. So let's get rid of that horrible bleeping sound. All right. So let's just think about what you did. So we moved in here. There was no resistance from the enemy team. We basically walked in past the choke, which is actually really damn good for us because good teams probably in gold and above, are going to hold this choke, right? Or they're going to hold here. Better teams will hold up here and just destroy you as you come through with tons of fire. Maybe they drop down from the high ground and contest here. But basically, most of the time, you'd expect the team to be here blocking your entrance through. But that is just not the case in this game. So consider this. We've been able to walk through the choke. This is massive. Where do we want to be as soldier here to get massive value? Because we want our problem to become target priority, not just running around trying to survive. Apologies, ladies and gentlemen. I'll just take a quick drink. Good Lord. I've got some like pumpkin spice thing from Starbucks. I don't even know what I'm turning into. I legit went to a Starbucks drive-thru. Somebody help me. Oh my God. It's quite nice though. Anyway, so you're in here, right? Which is great. Our first thought should be, all right, we can pile damage into the enemy team here, which is fine. And we can do. So you're here now, but we know this is after you ran around here and had like a little bit of a jig and then ran all the way back, then came here. So imagine if we didn't do this, right? And what we did instead was we run through here. We're like, oh my God, what's going on? Maybe we take a bit of a fight with that Moira. Maybe we even kill that Moira with better aim. And it's got to be said, this is a bronze game, so aim is going to be, you know, not great. Although you do look fairly stable as an aimer. You just need to get more time in, I'd imagine. Why don't we do this? Why don't we access the high ground? If we get here, suddenly we've got sight lines over the entire point. This is invaluable because it means we can hit targets here, targets there, everywhere, right? This is where we want to be. Here is great. On the ground here is like not too bad. I mean, in this case, as we play this, I'm sure we'll probably do kind of okay because we seem to be taking control of the point. Winston's getting healed. Okay, let's jump back on board with you again because this is... Where have you gone? There you are. All right, so we're running straight in. I'm going to kill this Reinhardt. This D.Va, sorry. Kind of, okay. Right, so what I'm looking for now is if you stay on a target. And where is, like, what is the target priority here? Okay. Don't ever attack Visor there. That's a criminally bad thing to do. Also, if you're about to lose a point as well, guys. Okay, that was a fine helix. Yeah, if you're going to lose a point, guys, don't just panic all into it. Especially if you're soldier. You're not really going to get a ton of value. So, that was kind of messy. But, oh God. Yeah, so he's just free ult charge for our team. But, and also their soldier's coming back. Yeah, so they're like, just don't do this. Like, if you lose a point, see, because if I just pause this here, this isn't really specific to Soldier, but look at this map here and look at where we are, right? We should totally not be doing this. Like, the blue team should have realized this point was lost and go, okay, fine. This person wouldn't be dead. this person's email. I'm getting really confused because it's red and blue. Anyway, we would have been, I think we've got our, who's that? That's our, I think it's the Junkrat, maybe. It doesn't matter anyway. There's a number of people got killed. Basically, the blue team should have just gone, no, you know what, guys? We're not going to rush in. We've lost that point. Literally, the entire enemy team, good Lord, is on that point. How do I make this smaller? There we go. It's on the point, which is fine. These guys should just go, right, we just need to back off. You either set up here on the high ground, you set down here on the low ground, you just get ready somewhere to engage the enemies they come through. Preferably on the high ground here would be a good spot to sort of set up and just take control of that, because again, you get good sight lines as the defenders. But whatever, that didn't happen. It's fine. It doesn't really matter. Let's get back on board with our soldier. So, Helix Rocket. I don't think I've ever seen you fire this into the ground. Now, what you've got to remember about Helix Rocket, and when we get a good example for this, I'll show you. In fact, as we use Helix Rocket, I think. Maybe not that one. But firing it into the feet of the targets you're at close range, it's a guaranteed way of doing damage. It's much easier to... Also, we shouldn't do that, right? There was something you might not have sort of caught there, and I don't think it's on him actually anymore. It kind of is. You can see the bubble on Soldier. We just fired our Helix Rocket straight... We just fired our Helix Rocket straight into his bubble. There is no need to do that, because when Reinhardt's got his barrier up, we can actually shoot his barrier around the... why do I always not get this right? Okay, F7. We shoot the barrier, not the bubble, right? Just firing into the bubble doesn't really make sense. But the issue I've got here is you're just firing your Helix Rocket sort of as you're shooting. There's no like consideration for Helix as a DPS tool where we can get guaranteed damage out of it. Okay, we should be able to kill that guy because he's got no cooldowns. We can also melee at point blank range as well. So one of the things here is our team are actually doing quite well. Also, we're firing a lot at nothing. So this is going to be a good breakdown, I think, of using Helix. Okay, or we just die, which is unlucky. But we could also access the high ground here. There's new lifts on Hollywood that actually work really fast. If I just show you them. So you know they're here, right? This lift, you get onto it, it will take you to the high ground super quick. Now, this is a double whammy for us because we've got TAC visors. So imagine if you're where I am here and we're not dead to the Moira. Imagine TAC visoring from here. That is so much value. So there's a couple of things with Soldier that will just honestly level up your play. If you prioritize taking high ground all of the time when you can, right? You will just notice you've got a better field of fire, which will then allow you to... I mean, you see, like, for bronze, your aim is actually pretty good. I mean, did you see that there? We're going to go back there because that's actually the perfect Helix Rocket. So we're going to take a look at that. Oh, the perfectly bad Helix Rocket for me to sort of highlight what's going on. But yeah, if you're taking high ground, you're going to get a lot more value. Your aim, I think, is pretty damn good for bronze. And honestly, this is good enough for gold, this aim. It's just that, like, look at where we are here. Like, we're just, like, in the fight. Now, our team are winning the fight, but we're not really using... You know, our potential is this mid-range hit scan hero. Okay, so what I want to wait for here, I'm going to slow this down for the Helix Rocket usage, because this should be a guaranteed hit. Okay, but it's not, because what we're doing here is firing this Helix Rocket horizontally. We're just firing it as we're shooting our primary weapon, which is not really what we should be doing. So if I just jump back and forth with you again, and then if I show you this, right? So what we should be doing is firing it into the ground, because it will... It might not hit her exactly, but it will still cause damage to her. Because remember, Helix Rocket is an explosion. When it detonates, there's a small AoE component to it. So what this does is it guarantees damage. Now, of course, you might just hit her with it, which is fine. But firing it into the ground means that we might get a bit of splash damage that pops up and maybe hits her, right? The issue is here, firing it like this, we are completely removing the chance of getting any splash damage. And we have to hit like the perfect peachy Helix Rocket. Now, the problem with that is Helix Rocket is a projectile. Your primary weapon is a hit scan. So hit scan, this is dead simple. You know this, but I'm just going to tell you anyway. So hit scan means it just hits instantly. So it's instant hit, right? Bang, you pull the trigger, it hits the target straight away. Projectile basically means that, well, it's got travel time. That can be TT, travel time. So it actually exists as a projectile in the game world and then moves forward and then hits its target. That means if you're firing a hit scan weapon and then try to fire a projectile at the same time, it's just not going to hit. You'll notice as well that I haven't really spoken about Biotic Field at any point in this game so far. It is, I don't want to say it's pointless. It's not pointless. It's a good ability for Soldier. But you'll see value from that when you do things like go on flanks. Now, I'm not saying just go on mad flanks all the time. One thing I'll say here, though, is, and I have said this a lot in Overanalyzed, if you've watched a bunch of them, this will kind of ring true. It's a bit of a cliche, but think about what we should be doing next. Us standing on the payload here actually doesn't do anything. See, again, with the Helix rocket, right? If we fired that at the ground, we would have hit. So it's almost like you have to reset your aim really fast with Soldier. So going fully auto, I mean, right there, I would have just been drilling the Anna, right? I would not have gone for Helix rocket at all there. Firing into Anna, like, I just don't care. And then when I run out of ammo, then I'd fire a Helix rocket. Then I'd reload my gun, right? Because there's a chance if she escapes, I might hit her with a Helix. But when I go to fire the Helix, I will aim it at the ground and fire it towards her feet. I will not just fire it at her and try and hit her in the head. So here's, we're going to die because he's nano boosted. So this is a problem with our position. So we should, that is a horrible sound. We should not have been there, right? Look at where our team is. We've died. Anna, we've got our Sombra over there. We've got our D.Va. Where's our Reinhardt? Oh, we don't have a Reinhardt. Where's our Winston? Oh, he's dead. So Winston's dead in the spawn. We should have probably, what has happened to his gun? We should have probably just backed off there, but like, let's just run with it. Whatever, let's run with it. Like, I don't want to get too, like, lost up in things that I'm saying and then just suddenly notice a problem and go, oh, by the way, you should have done this. We were out of position there, but there was other issues that we should have been looking for. So the thing I was trying to highlight is we should have had some sort of plan, not been standing on a payload. We should have pushed forward, tried to take some sort of position up. Obviously, we kind of did, but it was as the fight had already broken out. We suffered. Okay. Okay, so I'm actually, like, I'm not, let's play this. I'm not too worried about what you did there. Tac visor, okay, we were grabbed and we tac visored. That's not great. But then you did actually identify, hey, you know what? I should go forward and try and get some value with this tac visor, and you kind of did. But there is something I want to highlight here, and it's again going to be that, oh God, not, wow, I've never actually been under the point. It's going to be up here, right? Why are we not using this high ground? So us sitting down here doesn't really achieve anything. Like, look, our whole team are there. Everyone's chill. Everyone's fine. If we'd taken this position up here, right, and accessed the high ground, look at where it would take us, right? We'd come all the way through here, and then we'd be here. This is a great position to be in because, again, you've got access to the entire point. Look at all the targets there. We could step out here, drill the Anna, drill the Torbjorn, smash the Sigma. It is a really powerful position. And the enemy doesn't really have much they could send up there to deal with us. I mean, they could send... Well, they just couldn't really send anything. So, yeah, it would just be a great position to have. Thing is, though, like, where we are at the moment is not too bad if we just respect the enemy. And we don't want to get... We don't want to, like, expose ourselves to damage here. Let's see what happens, actually. That's an ace sleep. That's really good. That might do something. Yeah, sick, poor Sigma's barrier was gone. Okay, again, I like the target priority. I really like the target priority. So, I'm going to be honest here. When you say in your email... you don't think you belong in bronze, you belong in gold. I'm actually going to agree with you. I think you do not belong in bronze, but I think the reason why you're in bronze is we do not... I haven't really seen Helix do anything in the entire game. We just seem to be running through the middle of the map and getting involved in, like, point-blank sort of battles, which is not really what I want to be doing or want you to be doing as Soldier. I want you to flank, right? I want you to take up positions where... Like, see here, this is a good example. How is that a good position for you to be in? We're literally staring down the throat of the enemy. We've got no damage mitigation, no barriers, nothing in front of us, and we're getting smashed. So nice EMP off Sombra. We should be able to clean this up. Also, stop jumping. Like, this is like a pet peeve of mine. The only time you should be jumping and firing with Soldier is if you need that little bit of elevation to maybe hit somebody who's on a high ground or something, right? You're, like, jumping up to shoot them. Maybe, you know, like on Hollywood, the example might be you're jumping to shoot someone in the back of the cafe, right, as you attack it on the first point defense, possibly. But jumping as you're firing makes you very predictable. Of course, with this new Soldier, the potential damage output is massive. It's way better than it used to be. But of course, you have to land the shots. Now, I actually, it's quite an elegant change that they've done to Soldier. In fact, I completely agree with giving him recoil. And we're taking a decent high ground position here, which is fine. We'll get onto that in a second. But yeah, it's an elegant way of making Soldier reward better aim. So if you've got good aim and good recoil control, then you'll just do more damage. But of course, you've got to hit these shots. Okay, let's see what you do. So there is, I mean, you could, like, be very cheeky and fire a Helix rocket into their spawn and then run back to this high ground. Sometimes I do that, but you've got to be careful because if they've got a Widow, they might just kill you straight away. Okay. Okay. And you've got... you know what? Actually, I'm going to really commend your target priority here. The Zen is the target. Oh, that's unlucky. We got killed by a Helix rocket. But the Zen was the target there, right? You could have argued that you could have took a position which was a little bit further sort of back there, so there wasn't as much of our body being shown. In fact, I'll show you. There's no point in me just sort of... So look at this, right? If we go down here to the soldier, or we just chill in this position, see how much of your body is visible because of where you're standing, right? So if we were standing a little bit further back, so if we're standing here, right, we can still see the Zen's head, right? If we're standing, like, you literally will be able to see the Zen, trust me, from this position, then you're a much more harder target to hit. But you've got to be aware, because they've got a soldier, his Helix rocket will impact the wall behind us and cause splash damage to us. But there is also a bit of an omission here. Why don't we have our Helix, our heal station down? Have we used it? No. Do we use it at all? Think about setting up like a gun platform, right? I think that's kind of a really simple way of looking at this. Yeah. We should have had that down anyway, and it could have been healing us if we took a bit of damage, which we did take, and we wouldn't have died then to that Helix rocket. Also, we could have... the cooldown would have been back up by the time we needed it again. We should not go out this way. We should go out the door the left way. It's faster. Again, like, this is the thing. This is with bronze players, right? You make these little weird decisions. But I do want to say, I think you are much better than a bronze player. Okay, so why... Why are we here? Like, why are we not up here? Again, it's a little bit of a different position. I think what's happening is you're just taking the fastest route back to the point all of the time. And it's not the play. Because we're very expect... Like, that D.Va's going to come for us, I can guarantee you. In fact, well, we're just screwed at this point because we're just going to get pushed back. That's fine. That's actually fine. That's a win for us. Doesn't matter if we die. Disengaging. We should disengage. We've got one health. We're literally one. We're not going to kill him. Yeah, his barrier is 1500. Like, we need to run away here. There's no way we can hold this. Look, so this is a lot of wasted time, yeah? We should have known, oh my god, like, the whole enemy team's there. There's no way I can do anything. So what I'm going to do is get my ass onto the high ground, right? And then I'm going to chill here, and then I'm going to get ready. As soon as they come round, I'm going to hit them as they come through here. That's what you do, right? It's dead simple. I say it's simple, but this is from someone who's played a lot of Overwatch and played a lot of Soldier. And the more you do it, you'll just notice results straight away and you'll just win games. Because Soldier is incredible at getting into positions which are super annoying for the enemy team to deal with. Like, not to mention the fact you can sprint, so you can get into positions really quick, right? It's really good. Anyway. Okay. So we're outstaying our welcome here because they are going to start pushing us here. That's going to be a problem. So we really should get on the high ground. Backing off would be like the lesser of... the lesser good option, I guess. I was going to say the lesser of two evils, but it's not. It's not even an evil getting onto the high ground. That's what I want you to do. Okay, that might do some damage. It did. They've lost their tank. Okay. So there is a little thing as well. When D.Va's defense matrixing, you just can stop firing. There's no need to fire into it. Obviously, the thing with defense matrix, when she activates it, there's a cooldown before she can activate it again. So when she uses it, when you see it disappear, then start firing, then she'll try and bring it back up again. There's also a Reaper behind us. See, oh no, he's in front of us. I'm not too, yeah, we shouldn't really be. Oh dear, hello. We should not have died to that. Like, we really should not have died to that. I mean, that is disgusting. That's actually disgusting that we died to that. Look at this. We could have run away from that. Like, we've seen the D.Va bomb coming in. Let's slow this down, and it'll kind of look even worse. So this is D.Va coming in. Here it comes, the big D.Va bomb. Let's go, D.Va. Huge play. What are we doing? Hello? Hello? I don't think we even noticed it. We literally didn't notice the nuclear bomb. Oh, my Lord. Look at him hiding in the corner. Reinhardt's like, barrier, please. Where is it? Let's have a look, Ryan. Oh, no, he's got 3 seconds on it. Oh, and then he's dead. Yeah, but yeah, we should not have died to that. We could have just run away. The rest of our team would have died, but we would have still been alive. This again goes back to that whole thing, doesn't it? With Overwatch, yes, it's a team-based game, but if you make good decisions more often than not, you'll start increasing your win rate, and if you can get it over 50%, we're Gucci, right? We're actually going to increase in rank over time. Of course, you'll still get leave. You'll still get toxic players. You'll get all that stuff because it is Overwatch. So again, why are we not on the high ground? Oh, no. This is bad. This is hellishly bad. This is so bad. In fact, it's criminal. Why? Like, what are we doing? Like, what is our Reinhardt doing? We need to talk about time, right? We need to talk about timing of attacks. When the fight breaks out, we can then tack visor. We have tack visored into the full force of the enemy team. Is that a sleep dart? That might be a... I think that's just Anna. Yeah, no, that is a sleep dart. Because she's got a little pistol out. Look. Yeah, so... Actually, maybe she sleeps her tank. No. Okay, it actually got et, I think, or it hit the barrier. But yeah, we're tactizing into this. This is Soldier's worst nightmare. Like, what are you actually going to do? Like, look at it. Look at it. It's disgusting, right? Consider this. We access the high ground. We run around the side like this. And as the payload gets pushed through, we stand on this. Now, in the past, you could have come around here and the lift would not have been here, or the elevator. And you would have just been like, oh, I'm all out of ideas and I'm dead. But not anymore. It will always be there unless they're on the high ground. You could come up here on the high ground and then we could go and tack visor them. And we could just spray the crap out of them. Because then that's going to make them do something, right? Either their Ash is going to have to kill you, their Soldier's going to have to kill you, the Diva's going to have to jump up to you, or their Anna is going to have to put you to sleep. There's four things there that they're going to need to do, and it might actually get Zen's Transcendence out of them. Instead, we do this. Which does nothing. In fact, that was as valuable as just you not using your ultimate and firing at the enemy barrier. Our team are winning the fight, and Zen's like... So this is a huge win for us because Zen has used his Transcendence, I don't know why, to run away. But these are moments where we laugh at the enemy team and we're like, oh, I don't know what they're doing. So here, this isn't too bad, right? This is fine. For nice. First time I've seen you do that all game. Do like that. You did. See, what I like about that is you knew that would get the kill. It was a guaranteed kill. You fired it into the ground. I like it. So let's do that more often, right? We shouldn't walk into Firestrike when it's been thrown halfway across the map at us as well. Again, we're on no high ground. Again, we're not flanking. Okay, we're a little bit of a flank. There's a Zen flanking for some reason. See, that's a good hit with the Helix Rocket, but we still should be firing it into the ground because it's still difficult to make Helix Rocket hit like that. And I think Junkrat got the kill. Anyway, but see, this is honestly such a pet peeve of mine because I think, oh my Lord, this is what makes people this rank where they just all sit on the payload. Look, everybody is on this payload. What the hell is this team doing? Okay, Reinhardt, yeah. Okay, Lucio, yeah. Diva, maybe. But what are you doing here? In fact, look at our Junkrat. He's got the idea. I mean, he's dead because Diva's just going to kill him. Goodbye, Junkrat. Wake up, Diva. Okay, Diva did kill him eventually. So, yeah, like, why are we not on the high ground? Like, where have we even gone? Where have we even gone? There we are. What are we doing? Look, why are we going back? What are we doing? Running back and forth. They on the high ground? What the hell is this? Oh, they've got a Pharah now. Okay. So this is even better for us, the fact they've got Pharah, because, I mean, just another target for us to hit. Interesting sound barrier, but again, we don't care what our team are doing. Go on, kill him. Kill him. Good aim. You see, that's good aim for bronze, honestly. And I'm not saying that, like, demeaning. That is really good aim. So all I'm seeing here, honestly, is you're just not... Your positioning is bronze. Everything else about you is at least gold. At least gold, honestly. The Helix Rocket usage is questionable, but even then, right, that's like an added extra bit of damage to Soldier, right? See, look, we're taking fire strikes. What are we looking at? Okay, we're getting a bit confused here. Okay, so we're looking for the Pharah. See, we've got to be wary of your position here. You are, like, really exposed. There's a nanoed Reinhardt behind us. I mean, that just was a massive cluster, so that's kind of okay. But at no point, what are you doing, Mercy? What's this guy doing? Oh, he gunned down our Lucio. Oh, Lord, my Starbucks thing went cold. Oh, dear. Yeah, so get on the high ground. I can't say it enough. Get on the high ground. It will give you so much vision over where the enemy are coming through. Oh, okay. I wasn't going to talk about that, but I guess we can. Rocket jumps. I mean, this is incredible. This is actually bronze. Like, I can't believe this apparently is a game which is 1,032 SR. There's no world where a bronze Soldier would ever rocket jump, like it would ever do this, right? In fact, I don't really think we need to talk about it because it was nice, but it's not really going to achieve anything. Although this is some sort of high ground, but it's not the bestest high ground. And we just jumped off anyway, so good plan there. But there are things you can do with Soldier's rocket jump, like you can rocket jump to the high ground on Hanamura, get onto the Mega Health building. There's a couple of ways you can do that. You can rocket jump onto the sort of pagoda inside the second point. You can rocket jump from the sort of central console on the point of Volskaya on the second point up to the high ground, which is actually really cool. And you can, I think you can actually jump the gap on Lijiang Garden. You can do a lot of stuff, right? I could just talk about that all day. It's actually really cool what you can do with rocket jump. But here, like, all we're doing is standing, like, the enemy are flanking here. We're going to be able to kill this Pharah. Yeah, that's good. Baby Diva, that's fine. I don't really know what the enemy team are doing. They're kind of, I think they're looking for an angle, but they're not really getting anything done. But don't die to that. But the issue I've got here is you are just legit on the front line. We are standing in their face, and we're just saying, come and kill us. Like, well, unlucky Lucio. Lucio tried there. I mean, it would have been good if Lucio beated as the Shatter came in, but I don't know. Maybe he didn't have it available. I don't know. And I'm not rewinding for that. I don't care, ladies and gentlemen. But this is a lesson in positioning. It's like, the weird thing here is I'm not actually going crazy and saying, oh my God, you're just spamming into barriers all your life, or you're just, you know, wasting. You're just bad. Like, I don't think you are. It is literally, we're just standing, no brain, in the middle of the fight, just shooting at stuff. See, this Reinhardt, like, that is insane. I mean, okay, our Reinhardt should have countercharged him. I don't think it would have mattered because the rest of our team died, but, well, actually, it might have done because, I mean, it's the Reinhardt that killed both of us, although we did lose our Junkrat. But, like, yeah, our Reinhardt should have countercharged the nanoed Reinhardt. But the fact that they nanoed that Reinhardt and then he just charged in is like, what the hell? But again, this comes back to, at no point, like, so this fight's over. Like, this fight is actually over here. Our only thought here is to run to the other point and hope we survive. Not get involved in a fight because we've already got our ult charge, so we're not getting any benefit there. We're not going to kill anyone. We're just going to die. Like, we're actually dead now. This is incredibly bad and actually completely encapsulates the way that you've been playing in this game. Helix rocket the ground. Because you just fed your brains out there. And it is sad because we should have just run away to the second point and just got ready for the enemy to come through. We should be taking a high ground position. So we should go out the left here. No, I'd always go out the left-hand door here and get onto the high ground. But again, like, you've got this sort of magnetism. Okay, we knew he was tap visoring. Why did we just run into him? So we've died again. These are deaths we shouldn't be actually having, right? If we're taking the high ground position and we're just hitting the enemy from above, we are negating their barriers. We're giving their Reinhardt a nightmare. Like, he's going to be like, what the hell? I can't protect the team. So, like, what is this? Again, like, this isn't a good position for tac visor because we're just walking towards the enemy team. Like, we're getting some value from it, I will admit, but it's a bad habit, and I don't like bad habits because they just proliferate your gameplay as you potentially increase in rank, and then you hit a wall, and then you don't know why you've hit a wall, and very much so here, where you've hit this wall in bronze, when actually your aim and your mechanics are definitely gold, but we're not actually in a good position to use them. So we're just feeding over and over again. See, so we're running out again. Okay, this is fine here. We're winning this fight. Probably didn't need the sound barrier. That's okay. But like, if I pause here, right? This is where we kind of want to be. So we kill this Pharah. Great. He met the D.Va. Great. Well, we can just run forward because it's overtime. I kind of didn't pay attention to the time there. But I think the tale of this video is Soldier is great for, well, let's just take a look at this, right? Because I think this is sort of like your the Soldier homework. And this applies to anybody who's looking to play Soldier. Now, I guess I can quickly touch on the counters for Soldier. Right now in the meta, it's anything that can dive you, basically. Doomfist is especially strong against Soldier. So if the enemy team have got a super good Doomfist that is coming after you and killing you over and over again, consider swapping. Or if you're on maps like, well, even on Hollywood, I guess, second point. If they've got a really good Widow or even a good Ashe that's killing you over and over again, you're going to have problems, right? And you might have to swap your hero. But apart from that, Soldier's actually super versatile and can just work anywhere, especially when there's high ground, right? Like, I always use like using Soldier on Numbani defense first point because the high ground's great. Anyway, so what I want you to do is think about your positioning, right? So we'll put P up for positioning, right? Dead simple, right? Access the high ground where you can. Right? Always go after the high G all the time. You didn't do this in this video, which is really weird, right? It's going to give you an advantage for attack visor. It's going to give you an advantage for target allocated, like acquiring target. It's just going to be great. You're going to have great line of sight. It's definitely what you need to be doing. In terms of value, like, this is just tied to positioning, and it really is tied to positioning with Soldier, because you can spend all day in Overwatch firing into barriers or firing into tanks that are never going to die, and they're just getting healed up. The supports are getting ult charge. We're not doing anything. We might have gold damage. We may even have golden limbs, but we're not doing anything. We're actually just helping the enemy team. So value is directly tied to positioning for Soldier. It is for every hero in Overwatch, but with Soldier, it really is. Because again, this is tied into the high ground. So you've always got to look for the high ground. That's your good position. It will give you good value. Then you can work on target priority. Now, your target priority, I really like, because you were not just spamming into barriers. You were trying to shoot people in and around barriers. I like that. You were going after the supports most of the time. Again, I really like that. Helix rocket usage, just consider firing this into the floor a little bit more. Like, fire it into the feet of targets so we get that bit of splash damage. And I think, honestly, if you do this, if you say to yourself, we haven't even spoke about flanking as well. I guess we could throw out an old any Fs in the chat for flanking, where when a fight breaks out, if you can sprint around the side, that's super strong. If you can sprint around the side, do a hit and run, and then run away, that's super strong, right? But a lot of the time, flanks are tied to high ground. So if you can do a high ground flank, right, it's even better. So I think this sums it up, this insane thing I've drawn on the screen. But you get what I'm saying, right? Soldier is super strong. Sort your positioning out, you'll get to gold. Easy. All right, guys, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember, you can send in your own clips for consideration to appear on OverAnalyzed if you go to unitloss.com/overanalyzed. And yeah, thanks, guys. If you like the video, do sub, click the bell, like the video, all that good stuff. And I will catch you guys on the next video. Toodaloo.